Good morning, everyone, and welcome to the ribbon cutting ceremony of the House of Prayer Ministries by Faith. On behalf of our pastor, Victor and Walker, and our First Lady, Sister Linda Walker, and the entire House of Prayer Ministries by Faith family, we are overjoyed that you have chosen to celebrate this joyous occasion with us. 13 years ago, the Lord gave this man a vision, and it began with 8 young children. We are so excited about what the Lord has in store for us. We just ask that you continue to pray with us as we continue on the journey that the Lord has set out for us. And we hope that we will continue to be a strong pillar of faith in the community. At this time, we would like to have a scripture reading by our own Reverend Sharon Jones and then a prayer by Reverend Felix Simpkins.
Deuteronomy 1:6-8. The Lord our God spake unto us in Horeb, saying, ye have dwelt long enough in this mount. Turn you, and take your journey, and go to the mount of the Amorites, and unto all the places high thereunto in the plain, and in the hills, and in the valley, and in the south, and by the seaside, to the land of the Canaanites, and unto Lebanon, unto the great river, the river Euphrates. Behold, I have set the land before you. To your fathers, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, to give unto them and to their seed after them.
Dear God of all grace and mercy, Father, we thank you for this blessing. We thank you for all that you brought us through to bring us to this place. Now, Father, let us possess this land. Let us be a beacon of light that you've called to bless this place. Anoint your humble servant, Pastor Victor Merle Walker, that he may be a blessing, a beacon of light, that we may follow the leader, that we may do great things in Park Forest for your name's sake, that you receive all the glory, all the honor, and the praise. Bless this place, Lord. Keep this place in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen. At this time, we would like to have a few words by the Honorable John Osterberg.
Thank you very much, and welcome to the community. Our churches in Park Forest have always been the backbone of our community from the very beginning, and we are always eager to have new congregations come to the community. We encourage you to join in the affairs of the community. We have a number of activities. We have boards and commissions on which individuals can volunteer. We're always looking for participation of the citizens. We believe that that's really the backbone of Park Forest. The history of Park Forest has been one of sharing and diversity, both culturally, ethnically, and we want to continue to promote that for the years to come. So we are very proud and happy to have you.
Church in the community, as we say, to help the community. So we come here today saying we're here to be a beacon of hope in this place, in this community.
Now we will count backwards from 10 to 1. When we reach 1, if the youth will release the balloons to show our new beginning, and if the trustees and our pastor and first lady will cut the ribbon at that time. Everybody, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh no, they're gonna get, they're nailed in the, they're in the tree.
Good job, Balloon. Hey, no, that one got a chance. That one got a chance.
Go keep that boy quiet.
Oh, my leg.
Very nice, very nice. Very nice. Well, glad they're here. Very nice. You didn't want the church to sit in.
Yeah.
Trustee Gary.
Yeah, Gary, my husband, and Mae, and so many.